as a doll Barbie.
But is she really all that she seems?
Barbie influences girls' self-esteem and creates a false image on how girls should look.
But that's not all. Let's take a look.
Ruth Handler is the inventor of Barbie. She was the co-founder of Mattel Toy Company. She first got inspired by a German doll, Bilderli, who was in fact based on a post-war German cartoon prostitute. Barbie was named after Ruth's daughter, Barbara Handler. Barbie first debuted in 1959 through Mattel Toy Company. Ruth's primary purpose was to create a doll that could be a good role model for her daughter. And look how that turned out.
Barbie's figure has caused a lot of conflict over the years. These conflicts were caused by Barbie's measurements, if she were a real person, of an outstanding 39-inch chest, 19-inch waist, 33-inch hips, and 6 feet tall, compared to the average measurements of a fully grown woman, which are 36.5-inch chest, 30-inch waist, 41-inch hips, and 5.4 feet tall. Since Barbie's body was built to be standing on her tippy toes, it would be almost impossible for her to stand up straight.
Barbie's neck is twice as long as the average human's, which would make it impossible for her to hold up her head. Barbie's legs are 50% longer than her arms, whereas the average woman's legs are only 20% longer.
If a woman had the same measurements as Barbie, she would not have enough body fat to menstruate. In fact, if Barbie were a real person, her waist would be 39% smaller than an average anorexic patient.
In the United States, there are an average 8 million people who have some sort of eating disorder, of which 85 to 90% of them are female. 80% of those are claimed to have started worrying about their body shape and weight when they were around 4 to 6 years old. That is the typical age when kids get their first Barbie doll. Many of these women admit that Barbie has had a huge effect on their health habits. They were led to believe that Barbie was perfect and that the only way to live a perfect life was to have the Barbie look.
For example, Galia Slayen, a young woman with an eating disorder, says, "I'm not blaming Barbie for my illness. She's one small factor, an environmental factor. I'm blonde and blue-eyed and I figured that that was what I was supposed to look like. She was my idol. It impacted the way I looked at myself. I admired her perfect blonde locks and slim figure. Barbie represented beauty, perfection, and the ideal look for young girls around the world. Well, at least as a 7-year-old, that's what she was to me."
A Slumber Party Barbie came out in 1965. In the set, there are a few things that can help us prove our point. The first thing was a scale permanently set to 110 pounds, which is significantly lower than the average female of her height. The average female is 30 pounds more. The second was a book entitled How to Lose Weight. Inside the book, the only advice they gave was, don't eat. In general, Barbie has led to people making life-changing decisions, for example, starving themselves.
The famous Barbie look is big blue eyes, silky blonde hair, glossy lips, and a voluptuous curvy figure with a thin waist and large breasts and hips. There are many young girls who try to imitate this appearance, because that is what they consider beauty.
Some girls in more extreme ways than others. One example of this is Valeria Lukyanova, a 22-year-old model for V Magazine who claims to be a human Barbie doll.
She was influenced by Barbie from a young age. In her opinion, a beautiful girl has to have big blue eyes, straight blonde hair. She's altered her natural self to fit this description.
Sarah Birch spent over $1 million to get the Barbie look. She claims that every woman should go through this surgery. It makes people feel more confident.
Now let's take a look at what other people have to say.
How do you think Barbie affects girls' self-esteem?
I think that Barbie affects girls' self-esteem because she's always like perfect in her body. She's always like really skinny and her makeup's like always like really like well done and stuff, and she always has like a boyfriend and her hair is like always perfect and stuff, and she's like blonde, so a lot of girls might want to like be blonde because they feel like superior.
How do you think Barbie has influenced society's vision of beauty?
Well, a lot of people view Barbie as perfect, so a lot of girls try and make themselves look like her. But really, Barbie's just like a plastic doll. And
how do you think Barbie has influenced society's vision of beauty?
Little girls, when they play with Barbies, I guess they want to be like Barbie and they want to look like Barbie. So I'm sure there's Barbie apparel and everything. But girls, you know, little girls want to be just like Barbie. If they don't have the same body type, they'll try to change that. So the little girl skips dinner because she wants to look more like Barbie. That's kind of sad.
Can you please describe Barbie?
She's like a big, tall, like white girl with lots of pink clothes and stuff, you know.
I find that Barbie isn't really a great thing because it creates an image in girls' minds of what they should be, even though they're not.
What does Barbie look like?
She's not really meant for girls because she doesn't dress properly like women should.
After thorough research and several interviews, we have concurred that Barbie has had a huge influence on girls' self-esteem and society's perception of beauty.
Thanks for watching!